young men in the span of 1 week to commit suicide because they were taunted and tormented for being gay. Kathy Griffin, Wanda Sykes, Tim Gunn, Lance Bass, and Nate Berkus are here with their stories of personal pain and heartache and the drastic action one of them considered as his only escape. Next on Larry King Live. Good evening. Wanda Sykes is an openly gay comedian. She performs October 15th and 16th at Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas. Kathy Griffin is a gay activist, comedian, and actress, the star of Bravo's My Life on the D-List. Tim Gunn stars in Project Runway. Tim is gay, and he attempted suicide at age 17. And Lance Bass, openly gay performer, former performer with NSYNC. He says, get this, that in high school he made fun of gay kids to hide his own secret. Lesbian, gay, and bisexual youths are up to 4 times more likely to attempt suicide than their heterosexual parents, their peers, rather. And the Trevor Project staffs a national 24-hour, toll-free, confidential suicide hotline for gay and questioning youth. Just remember this, 866-4-U-TREVOR. 866-4-U-TREVOR. Why are they bullied? Why are gay people bullied? For what purpose?
For the purpose?
I mean, what's the reason? Why would someone bully someone
gay? I think it stems with society. I mean, when society as a whole has basically told the kids that it's okay, that we're a group that you can pick on, that you don't have to treat as equal. I mean, we see that in the laws and everything else that's out here. In the churches, that they preach that homophobia is wrong. You pretty much are giving kids permission to disrespect and to cause harm to the gay and lesbian community.
Tim, you see that as a good reason?
Well, Larry, I think that it's also fear-related, fear of the unknown. It stems from insecurities. I believe that there are many issues around this. I also want to add, when Wanda cites the churches, the Human Rights Campaign has a statistic, which is that there are still 33 states in this nation where one can be fired for being gay. So that puts gay people in the same category as those who are committing heinous crimes. And what does that really mean? It's a conundrum for me.
Do you think, Kathy, that society, heterosexual society, looks the other way?
Look, let's cut the crap. I think that the way that we had trickle-down economics in the 80s, this is trickle-down homophobia. And I really want people to connect the dots. And that's why I believe there's a connection between Prop 8, Don't Ask, Don't Tell, and now the string of teen suicides. It's almost sanctioned to bully gay people and treat them as second-class citizens. And I get very nervous when the parents of these so-called bullies defend them, saying, oh, kids will be kids. When you find out that the teen suicide rate is 4 times higher for a gay person, think about how tragic suicide is, period. But why would you want to make it 4 times higher, and for what? These kids are just being themselves.
Now,
so
Lance,
I think a lot of the so-called religious leaders play into it, and the politicians certainly aren't doing enough. There's a lot of very right-wing conservative people that absolutely sanction this behavior, and there's a lot you can do to finally put a stop to it.
You're not saying that this religious person would say it's okay to bully a gay person? They may say...
Really? Have you talked to Jim DeMint today? I mean, there's a...
He would say it's okay to bully someone.
He doesn't think there should be gay teachers. So, yeah, what I'm saying is that when I say so-called religious leaders, I mean, because not, of course, all religion is bad, but there are a lot of people under the umbrella of I'm a religious leader, or, gee, I don't mind gay people, I just don't want them in my church, I just don't think they should marry, I don't think they should serve openly. I did an episode of My Life on the D-List where I talked to a gay serviceman who said he was in the barracks with his pal in Iraq, who said, you know what we should do? We should go hang a fag from a tree outside. He thought that was his friend. He was serving in Iraq. So this is all kind of sanctioned quietly at this point.
Now Lance, hold on 1 second. Lance, you were a member of one of the most popular groups ever in this country. Now, you made fun of gay kids in high school to hide your own secret.
That's
Didn't
right.
Didn't you think you were harming your own kind, in a sense?
You know,
Didn't you feel bad when you did that?
You know, as a kid, you don't think of it like that. When you're 13, 14, you just go along with what the other people are doing. You just want to fit in. You want to make sure that your friends like you. So, yeah, you're going to crack jokes. You're going to laugh along with it. And when you're a teenager, you're not really thinking, oh, I'm being a bully by laughing along with it. You think, okay, a bully is just someone that can physically go and harm someone for being short, for being black, white, whatever. But, you know, you're also a bully by condoning the behavior and making the jokes along with them.
Do you think the bullier feels better about bullying someone he thinks is less than himself? I mean, what do you get out of bullying?
I really don't know what they get out of it. I mean, I've never been a bully.
Have you been bullied?
Larry, nobody's gonna bully me. Come on now. No. No, but
I have.
No.
I've been bullied, and you know what hurts? The collusion. I remember one time I was just getting my butt kicked in a park, and I was a little kid, and I'll never forget a guy walking by with a briefcase, just walking by. And I feel like at this time, we can't be that guy anymore. We can't walk by anymore. Yeah. That's why it's important to get involved with places like the Trevor Project. And as I travel the whole country, as you do, you meet all kinds of people, and I can't believe how many people come up to me at shows, and they'll say, until your show, I don't think I've ever sat next to a gay person before. So the word is...
Weird.
They're out there. We're all out there.
Tim, in your book, Guns, Golden Rules, Life's Little Lessons for Making It Work, do you write about this at all?
I do, Larry. I certainly talk about the bullying that I experienced and about the how marginalized that I felt. And it was serious enough, and I felt desperate enough that I wanted to end my own life. And I'm very lucky that my suicide attempt was not successful.
Last week, Ellen DeGeneres spoke out on her show. Take a look.
Being a teenager and figuring out who you are is hard enough without someone attacking you. My heart is breaking for their families, for their friends, and for our society that continues to let this happen. These kids needed us, and we have an obligation to change this. There are messages everywhere that validate this kind of bullying and taunting, and we have to make it stop. We can't let intolerance and ignorance take another kid's life. And I want anyone out there who feels different and alone to know that I know how you feel. And there is help out there, and you can find support in your community. If you need someone to talk to, or if you want to get involved, there are some really great organizations listed on our website. Things will get easier, people's minds will change, and you should be alive to see it.
Five people hung themselves within a week. Seth Walsh in his California backyard, September 19th. The Rutgers University freshman Tyler Clemente, 18, jumps off the George Washington Bridge, September 22nd. Asher Brown, 13 years old from Houston, shot himself in the head on September 23rd. Raymond Chase, 19, hung himself in his dorm room in Rhode Island on September 29th. And on September 30th, a 14-year-old Indiana boy ended his life. Kathy, you've been to Iraq, even talked with gay soldiers who were bullied in the military. Let's take a look at that.
Are there certain people in your unit that you feel like would be the type of person that would tend to out you and you kind of stay away from them?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm more worried about the violence and possible gay bashing because there is so much just accepted hate because of like the whole policy, because I would become like really good friends with this one person and he wouldn't know that I was gay, and when we were at core school, he just out of nowhere he said, I think we should hang gay people out in front of the trees so they know they're not welcome here. And I was like, what?
Wow. How do you respond to someone saying that to you?
I couldn't say anything. Like, that killed me.
And later on off camera he said he didn't use the expression gay person.
By the way, Kathy's gonna have a special announcement. It's coming up next. Don't go away.